The blogging landscape is constantly evolving, and we all know how crucial it is to stay ahead of the game. So thank you for giving Content AI a try. It shows that you are committed to adapting to change. In this video, I will walk you through step by step on how to set up and use Content AI to its fullest. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one WordPress SEO plugin that constantly strives to provide you with the fastest and the most cutting-edge SEO tools. And if you're watching this on YouTube, do subscribe to us as we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. But anyway, let's get you started with Content AI. Here's how you can access your RankMath account and check your subscription. On rankmath.com, at the top menu, click on My Account. Log into your account, and you will see all the available product downloads. Content AI is integrated with RankMath, so you don't need to download a separate plugin for that. I'll show you how to activate it in a while. Now, the first thing you need to look out for to utilize the Content AI credits is if your site is connected to this account by clicking on this Websites tab. Assuming that I'm starting this new website without RankMath installed or connected to an account, take note of the URL. This site is not connected to the RankMath account. I will walk you through how to install the plugin and connect your site with your RankMath account. Installing RankMath on your site is easier than you think. The free version is all you need to use Content AI. You don't need the pro version. But of course, there are so many more benefits to the pro version. You can explore this link to find out more. But anyway, to install the free version of RankMath, you'll need to log into your WordPress backend. And once you have done that, hover over Plugins and click on Add New. On the search bar, search for RankMath, and here's the plugin. Click on Install Now and activate. And now RankMath is installed on your site. If you want to install RankMath Pro, you've got to visit your account and download the plugin file to your computer. Then similarly on your site, on the Plugins tab, click on Add New. And instead of searching for a plugin, you want to click on Upload Plugin and select the file you have just downloaded. And click on Install Now. Following that, activate the plugin. And now RankMath Pro is installed on your site. Now it's time to connect your site to your RankMath account. As you saw, after installing and activating the RankMath Pro plugin, you will be prompted to connect this site with your RankMath account. And even if you have installed the free plugin, you will see something like this that will prompt you to do the same as well. As you click on Connect Now, if you are already logged into your RankMath account, you will see something like this. Click on Activate Now, and now your site is connected to your RankMath account. Go back to the account, refresh it, click on Websites, and now you will see your site is connected to it. It should be pretty straightforward, but if you want a guide on this, feel free to check out this link. However, if you already have RankMath installed on your site, but it is not connected to the account, all you need to do is to hover over RankMath SEO, visit the dashboard, visit the Help tab, and connect this site to your account. Simple as that. If you have a business or agency account, when you visit the Websites tab, you will see these options here. This is for you to set the maximum number of track keywords for this particular site, and this is to set the maximum Content AI credit usage for this site. For example, I have the expert plan for Content AI, which gives me 30,000 credits per month. So if I want to assign a limit for this site, say 10,000 credits, I will click on Set Limit, type 10,000 here, and click on Save. This number right here tells you how many credits have already been used up for the month for this site. Take note that Content AI credits will not accumulate if unused. All credits will reset every month. So this way you can easily manage the usage limits for each site. Now let's talk about how to check the available credits on a specific site. So the Content AI module is turned on by default. But if you don't see this menu item, you need to visit RankMath's dashboard. Look for the Content AI module and turn it on. As soon as you have done that, you will see the module on the menu. Now let's visit the Content AI module. And if you ever encounter this where you have a Content AI subscription and you have connected your site to the account, but still you can't seem to access the module, what you need to do is to visit RankMath's general settings. And on the Content AI settings, scroll to the bottom and you will see the available credits for your site. Clearly, the content AI credits have not been refreshed. So if you see zero here, all you need to do is just to click on this to refresh the available credits. And once this credit is synced with your account, visit Content AI again, and now you can access its features. The important thing you need to do is to make sure that Content AI is available where you need it to be. As you scroll to the bottom of the settings, you can choose whether Content AI should appear in any of these post types. For example, currently the post is not selected. As you visit any post on the WordPress editor, you will not see the Content AI option at the top right corner. So if you want Content AI options to appear on your post, then on the settings, select post, save changes, head back to the post again, refresh the page, and now you will see the Content AI tab right here. RankMath will detect all the different post types you have on your site, so select them appropriately. Now let's talk about the other default settings. This default country setting is mainly for the research feature, which I will show you how it works in a while. Currently, the default is worldwide, but if you head back to your settings, for example, my target audience are people in Singapore, and my content only serves people in Singapore, I will select Singapore as the default country. And as I save changes, head back to any posts or pages where Content AI is available, refresh the page, and now the default country in the research feature will be changed to what I've selected in the settings. So it really depends on who your site's target audience is. The default settings here will make it more convenient for you to use Content AI. If your target audience is people from all around the world, select worldwide or leave it as it is because this is selected by default. Now let's talk about the rest. Now on almost all Content AI tools, for example, the blog post introduction tool, there will be variables such as the audience, tone, and output language for you to select. So by default, the general audience, the formal tone, and the US English language are selected for you. But if you want to change any of the defaults for your convenience, you can do so on the settings as well. For example, you know your target audience is always going to be bloggers. So instead of having it as general audience, where you have to change it constantly, you can just set the default audience as bloggers in the settings, save it, and the next time you visit any Content AI tools, the bloggers will be selected as the default audience. Alright, that's all about the Content AI settings. Now, I want to show you some of the cool features Content AI provides. Let's start with the research function. Whenever you are writing an article and you're not confident how long the article needs to be, what secondary keywords to target, what external links to add to increase your chance of ranking, and many others, just use the Content AI research feature by clicking on the Content AI tab, right here. This is the keyword we are trying to rank for. Add this to the focus keyword field. Select the country this article is targeting. This is good for local SEO purposes. We've talked about this. Hit research, and Content AI will scrap and analyze the information on those articles that are ranking at the top of your provided keyword and location. Take note that each research will utilize 500 Content AI credits. Once the research is completed, it will give you smart suggestions such as how long your article should be, the approximate internal and external links your article should have, the heading count, the number of images and videos to add, then the keywords to include in the content together with its related keywords. It will also suggest keywords to be added to your headings. This will often tell you what topics you should cover in your article, then the keywords to add in the SEO title, as well as the SEO description. It will also suggest questions you should answer in your article. For the keyword we have provided, there are no recommended questions, but for other keywords such as home gym versus gym memberships, as you visit the suggested questions, you will have a list of questions here. Now to add an FAQ schema to all these questions, simply click on this button to copy all questions and paste them over at your content area. The FAQ schema will be added for anything within this block. Now the best thing about this is that Content AI can write the FAQ answers for you with a simple click. And here we go. Feel free to tweak this if you want to. Though Google will only feature this accordion reach results for only a limited set of government and authority sites, the FAQ schema is still good to have because schema generally helps search engines understand your content better. Now, most importantly for the research feature is the external link suggestions. Content AI has deemed there are no good external links for this topic. But for other topics, there will be link suggestions because not all topics will have credible sources to link to. And just for your information, if you link to a low quality page, it may hurt your overall site. Hence, this external link suggestion tool will suggest only credible sources that you can safely link to. And you can take comfort from this. Now, one more thing I need to mention is that you can sync the suggestions here with the analysis here by simply making sure that your main focus keyword has the same letter casing and exactly matches the focus keyword you have entered in the research tool. Typically, everything will be in small letter casing, even though you have entered in other styles. So just make sure that both the focus keyword here and the main focus keyword in the SEO analysis are the same, and you will see that the suggestions here will be synced with the smart suggestions. This is so that your SEO analysis will now be based on best SEO practices and dynamic checks. So this research function is one of the key features of Content AI. Now, let's talk about the other core features. If you are using RankMath as your SEO plugin, there should be no reason any of your articles are missing SEO title and descriptions, because we will add them for you automatically using these variables. However, should you wish to jazz it up, for example, I want Content AI to write SEO titles and descriptions for these articles here, all I need to do is to click on this to select all articles, head over to About Actions, and from here, you can see this set of actions is from Content AI. If you have a Content AI subscription, this set of actions will be activated. And this other set of About Actions is for RankMath Pro users. So if you have both the Content AI subscription and the Pro account, all these About Actions will be available for you. Now, you can have Content AI to generate just the SEO title, just the description, or both. Let's select both and hit apply. It may take a while depending on how many articles you have selected. And once done, you will see all the generated SEO titles and descriptions done for you. So this is for the About generation. Cool, right? Now let's talk about the SEO titles and descriptions when you are working on an article. Assuming you have written an article, visit RankMath's tab, click on Edit Snippets. Here's where you can amend the SEO title and description for the post. These are done for you by default, and this is how it will look like on the search engines. But if you want Content AI to write them for you, simply click on Generate with AI, and Content AI will go to work automatically. If you are not happy with the output, you can always amend the input here and generate it again. But if you are happy with the output, simply click on Insert and the output will be placed in the SEO title and description field. I believe you will find this feature useful. Another feature that is going to be useful to you is the ability to chat with our RankBot. RankBot is an AI assistant that will help you with SEO work. You can find it when you visit the Content AI module. On the chat tab, this is where you can chat with RankBot. And for convenience sake, instead of visiting the module, when you are writing your article, you can access it directly from the WordPress editor. Click on the Content AI tab. On the fourth icon, that's where RankBot is. You can start a new chat or continue where you have left off on your previous chat sessions. But for this case, it's a brand new website. I have not chatted with RankBot before, so this is the first chat session for the site. You can ask it to do any task. For example, asking it to find related keywords for your topic. Our topic is homeschooling versus traditional schooling. Keep your prompt within 2000 characters. Hit send, and it will provide you with a list of related keywords to be added to your article. You can also ask it to generate an outline for you, such as create an SEO optimized outline for the topic, homeschooling versus traditional schooling. And here we go. Then if you want to make your outline as comprehensive as possible to have the highest chance of ranking, visit the prompt library. Let's use one of the expert written prompts in the SEO category, such as identify topical gaps. Let's use the prompt. Copy the generated outline, paste it to the prompt. And now it will tell you the pointers that are missing from the generated outline. How cool is that? RankBot has many different use cases. If you want to understand more about it, you can check out this video or visit this link. Have fun with it. If you're using Elementor, DV, or other page builders, you can use Content AI as well. Content AI will be available on the site panel, just like how it works on the WordPress editor. However, you will be missing some features, such as if you are on a WordPress editor, as you click on a blog, you will be missing the Content AI command, such as you can write a command on the content area and have it run as command, and Content AI will generate what you tell it to do. If you're happy with the output, click on Use. Otherwise, you can regenerate or write more. If a paragraph is not long enough, you can ask it to write more, otherwise improve it, and it will create something better than this. And there are so many commands that will help you with your content creation. So if you want to utilize Content AI to its fullest while still using a page builder, you can work on your article using the content editor in the Content AI module. Writing your content here is just like writing it on the WordPress editor. If you want to learn more about the full benefits of the content editor, you can watch this video right here or visit this link. If you're watching this on YouTube, the same link is in the description. On top of all the features I've mentioned, there are over 40 AI tools for you to use. We have categorized them based on use cases such as SEO, where you can generate SEO title and descriptions and do topic research. The blog category provides you with tools that will assist you with running your blog. The marketing and sales category will assist you in creating content for your marketing efforts. The e-commerce category consists of all the tools that will make your e-commerce journey easier, and all the other miscellaneous tools that will help you with all other aspects of your business. We have dedicated knowledge-based tutorials and videos for each of these tools, so feel free to check them out through the button right below this video. Or if you're watching this from YouTube, the links will be in the description. Apart from all the AI tools we have mentioned, which may seem overwhelming, I want to introduce you to two writing features we commonly use to create content. The first is the AI command. Let's say that I want to ask Content AI to write an introduction about the topic RankMath review. On the content area, I'll hit double slashes. You can search for the blog post introduction tool by typing several characters and you'll find the tool here. Alternatively, you can give it specific instructions on what you want in the introduction. You can pause to read these instructions if you want to. As I hit enter, Content AI will start writing what you've instructed it to do. The more context and direction you give, the better the output will be. What do you think of this? You can practically ask Content AI to write any part of your article as long as you provide it with a clear set of instructions. The next available writing tool you can use is the Write tool. On the Content AI tab and on the second icon, this is the tool I'm talking about. This tool gives you the best of both worlds because it works like the AI command by giving it specific instructions, but you also have the variable inputs just like the other AI tools where you can set the tone of the writing, add relevant keywords to the output, as well as deciding on the length. The short option will generate 1 to 2 sentences, the medium will generate 3 to 4 sentences, and the long option will generate at least 5 sentences. We've added the same command as before. Let's have Content AI write the introduction in an informal and conversational tone. Add the focus keyword. Every new keyword you add, hit a comma and a tag will be created for it. Select the long option and let's hit generate. And Content AI will do its job. What do you think of the output? Similarly, you can use this tool to write any parts of your content as long as you have a clear set of instructions. Now, there are instances where you want to retrieve past generated outputs. For example, you have generated something from a specific tool and you have exited it. When you revisit the tool, all the outputs are lost. So to retrieve the generated output for this particular tool, there is a history button at the top right. Click on it. And now you will see all the past outputs generated from this tool. However, if you want to see the past generated outputs from all the other AI tools, then visit the Content AI module. You will see a history tab here. Click on it, and here are all the past outputs generated from all tools. So with this, thank you for giving Content AI a try. And most importantly, if you encounter any issues using the tools or you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to reach out to our friendly support team through this link. The same link is in the description if you're watching this on YouTube. Anyway, with all our efforts, we hope to bring to you the most cutting-edge tools to help you adapt to this ever-changing environment. And most importantly, thrive in it. This is Jack from RankMath. See you on our other videos.